Yeah, in the last video I explained about the data table. Right now I am explaining about the scenario manager. I already explained that number of units sold is 50, sale price is 11, revenue is 550, 15 to 11 550, and purchase price is 10, cost of goods sold is 15 to 10 500, before tax income is 50, income tax is 40% of this one, so 20, and after tax income is 50 minus 20 30. Like this, this is the data. And if you want to find different scenarios, if number of goods sold is increased to 100 and sale price increased to 12 and purchase price increased to decreased to 9 and after tax income decreased to something else, like this, what will be the happen to the after tax income or anything else, we have to check it. So for that one, we have to hear different scenarios. What will be the scenario if price is this one, number of goods sold is this one, purchase price is this one, what can be the scenario? These are the different scenarios we have to put. We have to result. We have to find the answers for that one. So for that one, we have to go to the what if analysis, scenario manager. Okay. The box will be appear like this. So we have to add like this. This is first scenario I am keeping. First scenario. In the first scenario, what cells you want to change? I want to change this cell, and this cell also. After selecting this one, we have to press enter and OK. What is the first scenario you want to see? If goods sold is increases to 16, price is increased to 12, and purchase cost of goods sold decreased to 9. This is the one scenario. Okay, and second scenario. Like this, you can give so many scenarios. This is second scenario. Changing cells will be same. And what will be the next one? 75, next 14, price, and this one, number of goods purchase price unit. This can be 8. If you take this as a second scenario, you can add third scenario also. Like this, we can add so many scenarios for the scenario manager. If you want 100, purchase price is 20, sale cost of goods sold is 13 rupees. Okay, next fourth scenario. For the fourth scenario, if it is 90, if it is 13, if it is 14, what can be the scenario? Like this, we can add. Every time you have to add like this. After finishing your scenarios, you have to click OK. Okay, if four scenarios will be appeared. After this, we have to click summary. Okay, in summary, what we need to do? What you want to? Scenarios are changed. Different scenarios we have observed. From this, what we want to see? What is the independent variable? We want to see what will be the before income tax for that first scenario, second scenario, third scenario, and fourth scenario. We want to see after tax income for first scenario, second scenario. Like this, we want to see for dependent. This is nothing but finding independent variable based on the change in dependent variables. Like this, nothing. Okay, I am taking before tax income and after tax income here and click OK. After clicking this one, you will be appeared with the scenario manager, scenario summary. This one, okay, this is the current values. This is the first scenario we have taken 60, 12, 9. For this one, before tax income, that is first one, is after. Okay, before tax income is for current is 50-30, and if it is first scenario, this one, say for second scenario, if it is sales is 75, price is 14, cost is 8 rupees, then this is the before after tax incomes. Like this, this is the scenario manager. If fourth scenario is sales is increased to 90, price is 13 rupees, and cost is 14, this is negative. So before tax income came as a negative value. Like this, scenario will go some. Thank you, friends.